Hello dear students, hope you all are fine. Children, have you ever been to the ocean floor? No? Come on then. Today we will go under the ocean and we will see the various landforms submerged under the water. Isn't it interesting? We know that the proportion of water and land is not equal on the earth. Around 71% of the earth's surface is covered by water. But there is land even below this water. We classify the various landforms on the earth on the basis of their structure or altitude. A similar classification can be done for landforms submerged under the water. Land submerged below oceanic water is called the ocean floor. And it is also uneven like the land on the continents. The structure of the ocean floor differs from ocean to ocean. Children, you know this place very well. This is sea coast. And I know this is your favorite picnic spot. You often spend your vacations here. As we go away from the coast, the structure of ocean floor changes. Now, children, we will gradually move deeper into the sea. Hey, we are under the water. Students, this landform, which is near the coast and submerged under the sea, is called continental shelf. This is the shallowest part of the ocean bed. It is also called submerged coastland. Its slope is gentle. Its depth is up to 200 meters below the sea level. Children, the continental shelf is very important from the point of view of humans. Extensive fishing grounds are found in the continental shelf. Do you know why? Because as this part is shallow, the sunlight reaches its bed. Algae, plankton, etc. grow here. This is food for fish. And fish comes here for eating these plants. Look how colorful fishes are here. And natural gas, mineral oil and various minerals can be obtained by mining the continental shelf. For example, Mumbai High, located on the continental shelf of the Arabian Sea. Let's move ahead. After the extent of continental shelf is over, the slope of the seabed becomes steeper. This is called continental slope. The depth of this slope is from 200 meters to 3600 meters. In some places, it is more. Beyond the continental slope lie the abyssal plains, which are the flat part of the seabed. Students, look here! Hills and mountains! These hills found on the ocean bed are called submerged hills and mountains. These hills are hundreds of kilometers wide and thousands of kilometers long. Peaks of some of the submerged hills come above the sea level. They are visible to us as marine islands. For example, Iceland in the Atlantic Ocean and Andaman Nicobar Islands in the Bay of Bengal. Look here, students. Plateaus are also found here. They are called submarine plateaus. For example, Chago Plateau in the Indian Ocean. Students, look! On the ocean bed, there are some landforms which are deep, narrow and steep. They are called marine deeps or trenches. Generally, the shallower ones are called marine deeps, while deeper ones and extending for longer distance are called marine trenches. We are also going to see the trenches. Hey, look there! That is a marine trench. Do you know? These trenches are thousands of meters deep from the sea level. The Mariana Trench in the Pacific Ocean is the deepest trench in the world. Its depth is around 11,034 meters. Hey, what happened? Why the land here is shaking? Maybe an earthquake is coming. Yes, children, the submerged hills and marine trenches are geologically the most active areas of the ocean bed in the world. These areas are earthquake-prone areas. And there are many active volcanoes here also. Oh no! A live volcano! Do you know? Earthquakes and volcanic eruptions occurring in the ocean bed gave rise to tsunamis in the nearby coastal areas. Now I think going ahead is not safe. We should go back, children. We came back again on this flat surface called abyssal plain. Oh yes! Let me tell you something important. The marine beds are the deep parts of the world. Hence, various deposits or things get collected in these parts. These are called marine deposits, which are of mainly two types. Natural marine deposits and artificial or man-made marine deposits. First, we will know about the natural marine deposits. Lava and ash erupting out of volcanic eruptions is found here. Fine soil particles are deposited on a large scale. Remains of marine plants and animals are mixed in these deposits. This mixture is made up of fine particles and lies in the form of fine clay. These are called marine oozes. These are mainly found on abyssal plain. Let's go back to the continental shelf. Here, pebbles, sand, soil, shells, etc. brought by rivers and glaciers from the continents. This deposition occurs mainly on the continental shelf. These are called marine sediments. Now, we will know about artificial or man-made marine deposits. We often deposit solid waste, sewage, radioactive materials, waste chemicals, plastic, etc. on the sea coast. These wastes are very dangerous for hydrosphere. These materials are extremely harmful to the marine life and its environment. Children, it's our responsibility to protect the hydrosphere. We should not pollute the water by depositing harmful materials in it. We should keep water resources clean. I hope, students, you have enjoyed this lesson. You must have learned a lot about the structure of the ocean floor. Now, an activity for you. Draw the ocean floor structure in your notebook and name the various landforms. Thank you so much for watching this video.